When you were younger, were you ever insecure about anything?
How much time do you have? I hated my hands. It's as big as my husband's hands. Weird.
Of course, number one, mukha. Pisngi, yung shape. Yung pagiging bilog na, lagyan mo ko ng plato, ka-shape ko yan. Pwede akong double ng plato.
They used to call me big eyes, halika dito, big eyes.
If you have thick eyebrows, that means you have a thick unibrow. And so people would be like, hey, you have so much hair here. So you have like caterpillars on your face.
Growing up, I was always kind of super self-conscious about my hair. Anyone around me would always say, why don't you want to straighten your hair? As a child in school, they would always bully me. They would like call me Santo Niño. They would throw paper in my hair.
Well, it's true, huh? I really don't have nice hands. Like, they're like shriveled little penises. No, like they're very manly, they're not long, they're very rough. Yeah, my hands were a big issue before. Like every time I'd shoot the TV commercial or something, I'd be like, why did the hand double na lang? So I'd have a hand behind me, I'd go like this.
It was always something that I really hated. And I'm so fortunate to have a mom who was very like, I love your hair, you're super beautiful, it's so unique.
Eventually I just learned to love them and I love that they're thick and it helps shape my face. You look back and you're like at pictures and you're like, oh, I looked fine.
It made you feel ashamed growing up only to find out. Big eyes are beautiful. It's the window for expression, ba?
Pag bilog ang mukha mo, you don't see that you age. Ang fresh ng face, plump. Pag tatanong nila ako, how old are you? So I'm gonna turn 40 this year. Really? Mag-40 ka na? So parang, okay. Nakakabagets.
Not my best trait to look at, but I do love them because they're the ones that make everything happen. Like I paint, I used to do accessories, like I love doing things like that.
I'm a jewelry designer and I do a lot of my things by hand. They're bony and calloused and long for a purpose.
When I realized that I wasn't gonna fit in and that I should just be myself and embrace that I'm different to everyone else, that is when I started to succeed in my life. My acceptance of my hair was the beginning point of being to accept my entire reality as a person. If I can't fit in, I'm just gonna be so different and stand out. And that is how I started my career. That's how I started to make my own clothes. I wear a corset because I've come to terms with my body, that I have a 50s body.
When you're younger, there's so much insecurity around you that you feel na you also want to be this perfect model type body. You know what, nobody's perfect and it's okay not to be perfect. It's the key to have a happy life. You don't have to be perfect. You just have to really accept that all of us are unique. And unique is beautiful.